हेलो डियर फ्रेंड्स, और टुडेज टॉपिक इज गो एंड कैच ए फॉलिंग स्टार। इट इज़ रिटन बाय जॉन डन इन 1633। जॉन डन बॉर्न इन 1572 एंड ही डाइड इन 1631। दिस पोएम गो एंड कैच ए फॉलिंग स्टार हैज़ बीन टेकन फ्रॉम हिज कलेक्शन ऑफ पोएम्स दैट इज़ नोन एज सॉन्ग्स एंड सोनेट्स। In this poem, what we find that his attitudes towards women is not good. Somewhere he seems mystical, somewhere he seems cynical, and he uses various negative aspects for the woman, and somewhere his tone is satirical for the woman, as his other poems. This poem is also full of paradoxes, satires and all. What we find in this poem is that he idealizes sexual love, but his motives in this poem are really suspectable because he is categorizing the human race with negative aspects, like he is very biased for the women. In this poem he shows that fickleness of a female woman. Means he questions her loyalty, he questions her faithfulness for her lover. And what is the conclusion from this poem? That poet seems very gender biased all over the poem. In this poem he uses far-fetched images, like all his metaphysical conceit. This poem is also full of far-fetched images. This poem is written is trochaic meter. Trochaic meter is the form of meter that is first syllable is stressed and another syllable is unstressed. Means stressed syllable followed by unstressed syllable. Now we come to the metaphysical conceit. Actually, what happens in the metaphysical conceit? In metaphysical conceits, poet uses extended metaphor. First of all, you should know what is actually extended metaphor. Metaphor means when we compare two things. Okay, but in extended metaphor, poet uses two different things which are very different in their nature, but one point of commonality used for that image. Poet finds somewhere something common in these two things, and he compares these two things and uses as his conceit. In this poem also, John Donne seems more logical than emotional. He gives scientific arguments. He makes some logical arguments. And in metaphysical conceit, John Donne go to a great length for comparison, like his other poem, A Valediction for Wedding Morning. He uses an image of compass. Basically, compass is a tool that is used in mathematics, but here in this poem, our poet John Donne uses for his imagery. Actually, what happens, there is an image of a lover and a love, his beloved. Lover is going somewhere for his job and all. Beloved is not happy for that, and he is trying to persuade his beloved that if you will remain at the center like a compass, then I will also be faithful to you. So these two things are very different from each other, but metaphysical poets can do and can merge two things together. I should talk about the form of this poem. Actually, this poem is written into three parts. There are three stanzas, and each stanza is divided into six lines. Okay, and the rhyme scheme of this poem is ABA BCC. Now we should explain, we should try to understand the text of this poem. So I should start the first stanza. Go and catch a falling star, get with child a mended root. Tell me where all past years are, or who cleft the devil's foot. Teach me to hear mermaids singing, or to keep off envy's stinging. And what wins out to advance an honest mind. In the first stanza, poet begins with a command, and it is imaginary that there must be some silent or some unknown interlocutor who is listening this command and who is ready to accept this command. Poet gives him command to go and perform various tasks, and these tasks are very much impossible for common man, but he is asking to go and perform all these tasks. The first task is that go and catch a falling star. First of all, it is not possible to get a falling star because it is not in our control that falling star will be there and we will watch. No, but on the another hand, poet is saying that you go and catch a falling star, and you go and get that mandrake root, resemble the foot of man used for black magicians. Means you get a mandrake root, a root that resembles like a man, but it is we can say a myth that we can get a child, we can get a child from the mandrake root. It can be conceived by a man, but it is not possible. Here also poet says that this impossible task can happen, but finding a faithful woman, a beautiful woman is not possible altogether. The third task is he asks for the feet of the devil. Go and clear the conception that who got the devil's foot. Next task is that go and hear a mermaid singing. First of all, we should know that what is a mermaid. Mermaid is considered as a woman, as a half woman and half fish. It is a combination of these two creatures. One is woman and another is fish. So when this fish sings in the sea, no one can hear their singing. But he is saying to this interlocutor that you should go and you should hear a mermaid singing. But on the another hand, poet is arguing that you can do these all impossible tasks possible, but finding a truthful, a beautiful, a faithful woman is not at all possible. So I think this is clear in the second stanza, or this is clear in first stanza. Now I will move towards second stanza. Second stanza is, if thou best born to strange sights, things invisible to see, ride 10,000 days and nights till age snow white hairs on thee. Though when thou return, will tell me all strange wonders that befell thee, and swear nowhere lives a woman true and fair. So this is the second stanza. In second stanza also poet is asking that interlocutor that you should go for a journey, and this journey will be very extraordinary. You will feel very invisible experiences here. You can see sights more beautiful, more extraordinary for the common man. But you should go and see the world and explore the world. For what? for a woman who is a beautiful and faithful both. So when you will go and explore these extraordinary vision, 1,000 days and nights will pass, and in 1,000 days and nights you will become old, and then you will come to me and you will report that all your hairs turn into white and gray. And what you will return and report to me that these fantastic experiences in your journey was very sweet, but finding such kind of woman till now not possible for me. Okay, so till second stanza, poet is very biased. He don't want to make any another situation that can be by chance possible till second stanza, but what find in third stanza that there are some 1% chances that that interlocutor can find a woman that may be faithful or beautiful